a licensed practitioner at Heart and Soul, and I'm honored to be facilitating our meditation experience this morning. This morning, we are taking the opportunity to immerse ourselves in stillness so that we may connect with the knower within in order that it be our guide during this time of change. Wherever you are, I invite you to make yourself comfortable so that you may be open to divine guidance. Know that right where you are, God is, and therefore it is a safe and sacred space. So if you are willing, I invite you to gently allow your eyes to close and take this opportunity to relax and let go of all that has transpired up until this moment. Join me in taking a deep conscious breath. Breathe in and release with a sigh. Now give thanks for your breath as you gently allow it to return to its natural rhythm. Take a moment now to notice the path your breath takes through your body. While the path our breath takes, like each of us, is unique, every breath is a part of the one breath which is breathing us all. Let your breath be an ever-present reminder of your oneness with spirit and its ever-availability as a guide and source of inner peace, love, and clarity, regardless of outer circumstances. As we enter the stillness, remember to focus on your breath, and I offer this affirmation as our guide. I have been that I have been. I am that I am, and I will be what I will be simultaneously. Thank you. I have been that I have been. I am that I am. And I will be what I will be simultaneously. I now invite you to return your awareness to the space that you are in. To do this, you might focus on your feet and notice and feel the support of the floor underneath. You might gently rub your palms together and begin to expand your awareness and feel the space around you. And when you are ready, I invite you to gently allow your eyes to open. This completes our meditation experience this morning. And so it is. Thank you for creating this safe and sacred container of love for our service. We have a wonderful opportunity during these times to spend more time being still and renewing our connection with the One. And I invite you to do so whenever and wherever possible. It has been a pleasure and an honor to facilitate this morning's meditation. Thank you.
Good morning and happy holidays, family. Welcome to Heart and Soul Center of Light's virtual Sunday celebration. My name is Ron Marshall, and I'm a licensed practitioner and founding member here at Heart and Soul, and I'm honored to be present this morning to let you know about opportunities to become engaged at Heart and Soul Center of Light. We ask that if you're joining us from outside of the Greater Bay Area, that you let us know where you're joining us from by letting us know in the chat. And again, thank you for joining us on this crisp, almost winter Sunday morning in the Bay Area. Our 2020 theme at Heart and Soul is Adventures in Faith, Expect a Miracle. And we are working with A Year of Miracles by Marianne Williamson. And today's selection is, actually we're on day 355. And the selection for today is, I base my identity on an eternal rock. I do not look to the world for comfort. I look only to God. We invite you to stay connected with us through social media using either Facebook, Instagram. Take a breath this morning, Ron. And all the other various social media channels that are available to you. And we continue to work with our community affirmation. Thank you for everything. I have no complaint whatsoever. Join our practitioners on Monday evenings from 6:30 p.m. to 7:15 p.m. for our Year of Miracles review. This is taking place every Monday throughout the rest of the year, and we're looking forward to continuing this in 2021 with you. And there's no Imagining Justice this Wednesday, the 23rd, or on December 30th. And IJ will be reconvening on Wednesday, January the 6th. And thank you, thank you, thank you, Heart and Soul. We sold out Oakland's Building Opportunities for Self-Sufficiency, also known as BOSS. We sold out their toy drive. So thank you to all who participated in that. And there are still opportunities to support BOSS. You can actually select items from the list on the slide, and they can be mailed to the BOSS Career Training and Employment Center at 1600 San Pablo Avenue, Oakland, California, 94612. You can also go to the link at the bottom of the slide, selfsufficiency.org/holiday drive. There are multiple opportunities there to give and support this vital service that is taking place in our community. And this is your invitation to join us for Heart and Soul's first virtual New Year's Eve celebration. It's our opportunity to release 2020 and welcome 2021 with Rev. Andriette and Dr. Will Coleman. It's time for us to let go of the old and call in the new. This will be happening on Thursday, New Year's Eve, December 31st, at 10 p.m. Pacific via Zoom. And please RSVP by December 27th at heartsoulcenter.org/NYE2020. And our sister Tammy Hall continues to support us through these times with her amazing talent and music on Thursday evenings at from 6 to 8 p.m. via Facebook Live, and that's Pacific time. Our sister is performing a wonderful, talented service during this time, so please make sure to tip her generously. And join us every Saturday at 10 a.m. Pacific on Facebook, YouTube, or via podcast for Reverend Andriette's Point of Power, our five-minute videos that are designed to inject a point of power into your day, week, and your life. And we recently moved, and thank you to those who have already gone out to our wish list on Amazon and selected items for us. It's also helpful just to do a gift card. That way it gives us some flexibility in terms of getting the things that we happen to need that come up in the moment. So let's take a breath, family. Our vision is our intention of who we are and how we are in the world. And each Sunday we have this opportunity to anchor this vision together. So together, We are a loving and compassionate world-class teaching and empowerment ministry. Through a consciousness of universal God presence, we release all resistance, separation, and fear. We claim our personal liberation and accept the eternal availability of joy, love, and abundance. Through our intention to be love and spread joy, we engender reflections of the same and more in others. Our ministry is a gift to the world, which expands through our practice and dedication. We welcome all people, and together we make a quantifiable, positive difference on the planet. And so it is. So join me in going within, family, by taking a deep, conscious breath. And we release the breath and we give thanks for it. How good it is to know that our breath is our ever-present reminder that there truly is but one life and one breath that is breathing us all. How good it is to know that there is a power and presence that is the universe that is available to everyone for our use. How good it is to know that all that God is, which is love and peace and joy and harmony and creativity and abundance and so much more, is available to all through right of consciousness. So I give thanks for knowing that the very same thing that kept us during the night woke us this morning. That the very same thing that is expressing itself as nature is expressing itself as each and every person that is within the range of my voice and beyond. So grateful for the truth of our oneness with the one, I give thanks this day and I speak my word on behalf of Heart and Soul Center of Light. I'm grateful for all of the transformation that is taking place in this moment. I know that we are each here by divine appointment and that spirit is forever pouring into each and every one of us all manner of good. I know that it is present in the entire body of our affairs, in our work, in our love relationships, in our finances. I'm grateful for knowing that God is, we are, and all is exceedingly well. So I give thanks this day for those who are praying without ceasing, our beloved practitioner corps. I'm giving thanks for our volunteers, both seen and unseen, who have laid their hearts and hands on Heart and Soul Center of Light in the form of their service. I give thanks for our board, which is going about the business of Heart and Soul Center of Light in loving and divine consciousness. I give thanks for our music ministry who ministers to us in word and song and note. I'm giving thanks for our founding minister, Reverend Andrea Earle. Grateful for her sacred yes. Grateful for her willingness to be that space through which spirit speaks. I'm grateful that there truly is so much to be grateful for, regardless of any appearances, ideas, and notions to the contrary. I know that the all good is ever present, and that as we turn our consciousness to the truth of who and whose we are, our lives are transformed. And so grateful for this transformation, I just release this word into the perfect activity of love and law. I know that it is done and done well because it is done in, through, and as God. For this and the more, I give thanks, I allow it to be, and so it is. Amen.
Good morning, heart and soul. Today is a very auspicious day. As of tomorrow, we will be in the winter solstice. And it's always this time of year. It just so happens that this is the eve of the winter solstice. It's typically the 20th or the 21st. And I mention it because it's a very auspicious time in 2020. The planets are aligning in a very specific way that gives us an opportunity to recalibrate. I wanted to just pause for a moment and acknowledge that right where we are, the whole perfect and complete nature of the divine is, and something quite magnificent is unfolding in and out of that. It will require our attention, though. This is where we celebrate the longest day of the longest night and the shortest day is what it amounts to. And across generations, for predating history, this has been important. It's been important because for folks who work the land, it changed everything. It changed food resources. It changed the time that community had together. It changed everything. And so for us, while it's a little different, I just want to share these words because I think you can begin to see how it is that we are celebrating the Christ Mast. That there have been, in this time of year, there have always been a number of festivals and rituals, and they marked the symbolic death and rebirth of the sun. They marked the death and rebirth of the sun. So we can see in our minds, I'm not challenging anyone's belief at all. I'm simply wanting to add to the mix that there really is a reason for this season at this time. There's a reason for Christ consciousness 24/7, 365. But the reason for this season and this specific time goes back predating history in a way that honors and marks the symbolic death and rebirth of the sun. So we have a special day planned for us. I want to just ask you, please stay with us to the very end. And I ask that of you because we have planned kind of most of the moments, and especially there is a musical offering at the very end that no one has ever seen before because it was created for us. And I want to make sure that you get to experience it, and you won't if you don't stay to the end. So with that, I want to offer that in celebration of Christmas, the Christ Mass, there's a little ditty that I want you to hear. And so I'm going to ask the ensemble. I'm going to get out of the way so that that can happen.
Thank you. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. Every little child is gonna spy to see if a reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if a reindeer know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to you.
Jesus, so holy, living in new life, new hope to all he brings. Listen to the angels sing, glory, glory, glory to the newborn King.
So we're going to try something different this year. I'm surprised we haven't done this before, but I've been thinking about the vibration of a name. And the name Jesus has a powerful vibration. But the original name, Yeshua or Yeheshua or Yeshua, always has an even greater frequency, a higher vibration. And so this time, I'm going to ask the ensemble to sing it with Yeshua. And I'm going to ask you to sing along just so that we can begin to feel the vibration. I often remind you that the master teacher, Yeshua, that the world ultimately came to Paul Jesus. It's all in the same vibration, but I'm wondering if we can feel the difference. Ensemble?
Yeshua. Oh, what a wonderful child. Yeshua, Yeshua, so holy, living in new life, new hope to all he brings. Listen to the angels sing, glory, glory, glory to the newborn.
All right, y'all, because we are all about new life and new hope, we must claim it for ourselves. Know that within our own name is a divine vibration that is the expression, the announcement of your nature. So that's what we're going to do now. Claiming new life and new hope is a part of who and how we are. So this time, we're all going to sing it using our own name. So let's do this. I'm going to sing it singing Andriette. I'm going to lip sync it in truth. But y'all are going to sing it using your name. Yes? Okay.
Felicia. Oh, what a wonderful child. Felicia. Felicia. So holy, living in mind. New life, new hope to all she brings. Listen to the angels sing. Glory, glory, glory to the newborn King.
Once more.
Felicia, Felicia. So holy, living in mind, new life, new hope to all she brings. And listen to the angels sing, glory, glory, glory to the new
indeed. Glory, glory, glory to the new birth of the divine Son in each, in and as each and every one of us. Oh, I love this, that today, this season is about new life, new hope. And it probably might have served some of you to, if I had paused to say that this part of the song that says, so holy, meek, and mild, that meek in its root, in its word as an origin, means teachable. So we're talking about that aspect of us that is open for the shift, because this is a time of rebirth. And in rebirthing, we don't need to take all that old stuff that we used to believe that we realize is no longer serving us. And so the opportunity is for us to begin to claim new life, new hope. To all, I bring new life. I bring new hope. We, each and every one of us does, and we must. I want to give just thank you, thank you, thank you. Nicholas Beard, Tammy Hall, Annie Stafford, and Daria Johnson. Just, y'all ain't heard nothing yet, let me just say. So, look. This is about giving glory to the new birth. Giving thanks also, lest I forget, to our ensemble. And it really is our shelter in place ensemble, because we are honoring that we only have so many folks in the building. And of course, you notice when anyone is singing, they have a mask and the playing is behind a shield. So we're doing our best to ensure that everyone is safe. And so in that sense, just a shout out and a thanksgiving for any and every iteration of our magnificent heart and soul ensemble. So thank you, one and all. This is truly an adventure in faith. Yes, y'all, truly an adventure in faith as we look very closely at what are we birthing? Who are we and what are we birthing? And in our birthing, what is it that we are consciously and intentionally focused on and willing to be, to do, and to have? So with that, let me just say again to you, Merry Christ Mass. That this is a celebration of the Christ consciousness. Here's what the words of Ernest Holmes that I'm offering you here is: to carry peace, love, and givingness to everyone is the meaning of the Christ Mass, Christmas. To feel that we all are part of the divine offering, to enter into the spirit of the birth of the Christ consciousness is in the human mind and heart. But here's the thing. We are not likely to experience these feelings until we first believe in peace and love. You know, as I say that, I know there are those folks who have given up, who have decided, who have a different sense of what is unfolding. And for them, they're not going to feel what I'm talking about. But for the ones who are still open and available to an experience of peace and love, for the ones who, why? Because it is done unto us as we believe. So those who are yet believing peace and love is happening even now and is unfolding in greater experience because we are focused on it, number one, and what we focus on increases. So if we're focused on our doubt about that, or some of us are busy offering evidence of the absence of peace, then that's what is expanding for in that one's universe. So I'm just saying that for me and my house, we's focused on peace and love. We're believing on peace and love. Why? Because the alternative does not serve in the way. And here's the other thing. That as we practice focusing on, believing in peace and love, it also shifts our sense of deservability. Our sense of deservability that we can live in a world that is expressing or is an expression of peace and love. So these are the holy days. These are the days when we declare that the presence, the very presence of the divine, the presence of God, the presence of the living one, the strong one, by any name, or it's about the nature, that the presence is the present. I want to make sure that you're hearing that clearly. The presence is the present, the ultimate present, that the presence of God . The presence of the divine. To meditate upon the presence of God is to indraw, is to be a magnetic pull of that energy. The universe, we're pulling the universe into our own soul. It's important to note that God is not a person, but a principle that is personalized in each of us. Spirituality is the atmosphere of this principle. The reality of every human is God. And that's from the New Thought Dictionary around the presence, so that we can be clear about this, that the presence is the ultimate present. Our new awareness of divine presence within us is called the babe, the wonderful child. I'm getting ahead of myself here, so I want to go back to just clarify that this notion of the presence, even looking more closely at it, is the babe, the new babe. It's the wonder child, also known as the wonder child, a miracle. Our dear beloved brother who you saw when he sent this magnificent 11th anniversary testimonial for Heart and Soul, Brother Ishmael Tete in Accra, Ghana, I've heard him talk about that the fertilization of an egg, that we're really talking about several million to billion sperm who are all working their way potentially toward an egg. Well, it only takes one sperm. But here's the thing, that each and every one of us is a miracle, because there were potentially a billion attempts at getting to the egg that had everything to do with who we are, but it was the other DNA that is contained in the sperm that make us who we are. So it's that combination. I don't know if you're really getting what I'm saying, that had any one of those other several million to a billion sperms, had any one of them made the connection, we would be different. And so we are, each and every one of us is the miracle of that experience. I'm wanting us to get that as we're celebrating the birth of something, I want you to know that the birth of anything is a miracle. The birth of anything, what is required to bring something to fruition, is a miracle in and of itself. We take it for granted. And if you witness the birth of a human baby, or for that matter, a cat or a calf or whatever it is, those of us who have witnessed a live birth, it is, I mean, you're just left in awe if you're paying attention. And what I'm doing today is calling us into paying attention. All of us have been here a while, but have we thought about our coming into being? Have we thought about how the planets align and how we experience seasons? Seasons is not just about you shifting your closet. That there really is something that is happening in the very core of universal life. And if we're watching it, if we're aligned with it, we begin to see that we're a part of it. I want to go to a double Dutch stance. That we're in this and we want to consciously and intentionally really get into it, to see our place in it, to see the divine, to see the majesty in it. Because it is our awareness of our primal power. That's what we're talking about at the birth of anything. It's our primal power. As we form a new concept of God that results, see, a new concept of the divine results in a new embryo. We are birthing something. We're creating the environment as we believe anew, new life, new hope. We are setting the foundation. There are those women who are preparing to get pregnant. And they have their practices where they know they're preparing their womb and that they're ensuring that their ovaries, they are taking the time and engaging in the practices that ensure that there is a positive and affirming environment. And that's what we are being called to be, a positive and affirming environment for what? New life, new hope. For such a time as this, yes? So this is about, certainly it's an adventure in faith. Birthing anything is an adventure in faith. I have been, in my preparation for this season, this winter solstice, this Christ Mass, it's all of that. I have been in my own process and with looking at my own ancestors, my own human path, if you will, and I realize that that I haven't always acknowledged all aspects of the family that our family includes, babies that did not make it to term. And so birth is a miracle. Everybody's story is not the same. So look, the spiritual son. And would it be okay if I say to you that in this context, it really doesn't matter how you spell it, because we're always talking about both things. We're talking about the planetary influence, the sun, the light. So you see how these terms coexist and are used interchangeably. The spiritual sun, we can be talking about the astronomy in that, but we are also talking about the divine expression in human form. That the spiritual sun was the guiding star that led the Magi of old to a place where the little child lay. So this is mystic work. This is a metaphysical story, which means that there is more than just the physical aspect of it. There's a lot more going on here that we're talking about. That they went to the place of good in our soul, where the presence of God is at the center of everyone's being. So it could be said that there were those men who went to a place, a manger. They said it was a carved out place in a cave, because there was no place in the huts, if you will, at the inn, they said, but it's not. I think often when we said the inn, it felt like, you know, the Days Inn. You know what I mean? It feels like there's a motel, a hotel. It ain't that. We're talking about little huts that we can imagine, like some of our little tents that could contain a number of families. But there was a lot of travel going on. Folks were coming to fulfill the census that they had to go back to their hometown to do that. It was by law. And so the town was full. And so it is said that they were really in a little cave, and the manger was a little nook within the cave itself. But we're not talking so much about the physical spaces. We're talking about that there's a nook in us where the divine can be is safe. That there's that place in our heart and in our being. It's not like a location. You know, I'm pointing to my chest, or you know, I can point to my hand, but it's not a place. It's an energetic field. The humility of the manger is the common place in every person. This is why deservability is key here. It is here in the commonplace that we must find the good. And finding it there, we shall also discover that the larger issues of our experiences are overshadowed by the same good that we have discovered in the commonplace. I'm trying to say we're never at the effect of anything that we're willing to let go and embrace new life and new hope. That we have way more power than we're exercising. It's about, see, I want to get to the real meaning of Christmas. I want to encourage us that we're not thinking merely of the traditional birth of Yeshua. So much as numbering the years backwards. You know how it's BC and AD and before the common era, all of that. But let us rather bring these years forward. Let us know something. Let us mark time in a way in terms of what it means to me that transforms my life. Making it my own experience that would then permit new birth to take place in my experience. You know, throughout the scripture, there are those stories of the women who were too old to give birth, who then gave birth. I'm trying to say something metaphorically. And then there were the women who just hadn't given birth, who were not able to get pregnant, who through their own processes, their own trust, their own faith, gave birth. I'm saying that for anyone that feels like, well, this ain't that, and I'm talking to the men as well, because we're not talking about having to have a womb, a physical womb, and ovaries. We're talking about an attitude. We're talking about a knowing. We're talking about a consciousness. St. Augustine said, what difference does it make? If Christ was born so long ago in Bethlehem, if he's not born in me, what difference does it make? And today I say that because there's a lot of noise around Christmas. But what difference does Christmas make if it's not changing you in any way? If there's nothing about you that is resonating with, giving evidence of a Christ consciousness. My dear brother friend, you will remember because he also sent a message. He's in Atlanta, the Reverend Dr. David Alexander offers us this idea of putting Christ back in Christmas. You know, we say Christmas and we have a whole thing that we do. We have our Christmas rituals, but sometimes they don't include the Christ consciousness, the reason for the season, if you will. So he says, let's put the loving and inclusive Christ, the one who made room at his table for all, let's put that back in Christmas. He says, let's put the forgiving Christ, who asked us to be generous in our forgiveness practice, let's put that back in Christmas. Let's put the born of a Middle Eastern refugee family Christ back in Christmas. He said, let's put the born of a surrogate mother and had two fathers, Christ, back in Christmas. Let's put the it was never his last name anyway, Christ, back in Christmas. Because when we just think it's a name, Jesus Christ, we're not in the energetic of it. Let's put this story has always represented a state of awakened consciousness in humanity, Christ, back in Christmas. Let's put the common Christ back in Christmas. Let's put the Christ consciousness that belonged to Buddha and Allah and Krishna and Muhammad back in Christmas. Let's put that Christ, which is in you, in me, in all of us. Let's put that Christ back in Christmas. I'm grateful to my dear brother David Alexander, whom I love and appreciate for his wisdom and his beautiful heart. In Luke 2 and 10, actually it's 10 and 8 and 11, I'm bringing you this message, hear my voice, drawing from that fear not. Fear not, today I bring you good tidings for all the people. You know, the message that the angel offered in that scripture in Luke 2 and 10 through 11 was the good tidings for all of the people. Because, you know, there were those who felt that the Messiah was just for them and that it was going to come to fulfill the law in a law and order kind of way. It was kind of standing like, oh, you gonna get yours. But in reality, we were all gonna get ours. This was a message for everyone. Why? Because unto you is born this day in Bethlehem, the city of David, the Christ consciousness for anyone who is willing and available. Yeah, the reason for the season. Christmas reminds us of the great spiritual ideas that the master teacher taught. And these ideas have not and will not change because they're the basic. They belong to every religion, every person, everyone who has ever lived or ever will. Yeshua expressed two great universal truths. First, that we are surrounded by divine presence, each and every one of us, 24/7, 365. Second, that there is a law of good that responds to our faith in it. It is said that the master teachers message, his whole ministry could really be synthesized into, it is done unto you as you believe. So as we are believing that we're surrounded by divine presence and that there is a law of good that responds to our faith in it, we then experience that according to our belief in it, our faith. It seems that we should think of this birth in our own consciousness as a realization of love, of truth, of beauty, of peace. And we should be filled with the awareness of the divine presence in everything and everyone. Ernest Holmes says, surely, surely, surely this is the true meaning of Christmas. I love this. In the 1960, the December issue of the Science of Mind magazine, it is written that it's impossible to understand the teachings of the master teacher, whose birthday we, and I add erroneously, celebrate this month. It's clear. Science says and theologians acknowledge in truth that the master teacher, Yeshua, that the world ultimately came to call Jesus, was born in the spring or the summer. But I'm not mad about that. I'm not even concerned about it. I just want to get us on board. I just want us on board honoring Christ consciousness. And if we're doing it all year long, it really don't matter when the real birthday is, in truth. But we celebrate it this month, and that's a good thing whenever we do. Unless, but none of that matters unless we comprehend the few basic principles from which he taught. And two important ones that are mentioned here, that Christ is the revelation of God to humanity, of the incarnation of the divine in human form. That Christ is the heavenly human, or the offspring of the one Father. And two, that some part of everyone's nature is universal. And that we are the individualized expression of the divine. That our true nature is divine, and that each and every one of us is a center of the activity of the consciousness of God. You see, my mission today is new life, new hope. And to say to you, fear not, this thing is all working out. That this is the good news, that right where we are, it's all unfolding in perfect order. The Christ is born in me. The Christ is born in you and in all of us. Every birth is a miracle, a divine incarnation of the eternal one. In 365 days for richer living, Ernest Holmes and Raymond Charles Barker wrote this: on this Christmas day, on this day, I let Christ, let's not limit it to Christmas for that one day, you know, December 25th. Let's not limit it. I know I changed it in my notes, but failed to change it in your slide, but we're gonna have it changed for you when you get the recap. So on this day, meaning every day, I let Christ rule my heart, mind, and affairs. I see the new birth of love in all people and all events. You see, that's going to require that we shift ourselves. Because right now we've trained ourselves to see a problem. We've trained ourselves to see that's going to be trouble. Future trouble. Not trouble yet. It's going to be future trouble. And we all about having the radar out for the future problems. But I'm suggesting we bring our energy in and we begin to see the new birth of love in all people and in all events. All the beauty of the Christ mast is mine to behold. All the love of the Christ mast is given unto me, unto each of us. Each card and each gift brings me love, and they bless me with the knowledge of my own birth of truth. See, we can do that. It doesn't have to be the gift that we question about how much it was and when it was received and from whom. Instead, they can all be symbols. They can be symbols of the truth, the birth of truth within each and every one of us. I shall be like the wise men and follow the eternal star of truth. It's within us. You'll see it wherever you look for it. Seek and ye shall find. I shall be like the shepherds and hear the voice of God in every harmony. Oh, challenge yourself this season. I shall be like Mary and Joseph and watch carefully over this new inner dawning of true life. I love to close our Christmas service each year with Howard Thurman, who reminds us that now the work of Christmas begins. You know, there's all the joy, the connection with family across the miles and largely via Zoom and other platforms in our current time. But here's what he says. He says, when the song of the angels is stilled, when the star in the sky is gone, when the kings and princes are home, when the shepherds are back with their flocks, the work of Christmas begins. To find the lost, to heal the broken, to feed the hungry, to release the prisoner. And many of us are holding prisoners in our non-forgiveness. To rebuild the nations, to bring peace among the people, to be the peace, the consciousness of peace, to make music in the heart. What does that mean? When you make music in your heart, is your heart not happy? So this is a way of saying to have a happy heart, to have a song of new life, new hope, new birth. And so I say to you, Merry Christmas. You are the gift. Truly the gift. And now, Nicholas Beard. Wonderful world indeed.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I watch them bloom for me and for you. I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky. They're also on the faces of the people passing by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? What they're really saying is, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They'll learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. A wonderful world. Thank you. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky. They're also on the faces of the people passing by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? What they're really saying is, I love you. I hear babies cry, and I watch them grow. They'll learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
In today's world especially, it's not easy to keep a center going. You know, often as a participant or a congregant or someone who's part of the community, we're not really thinking maybe about the electric bill and about all the many things it takes to keep a community together and growing. And so I invite us on this 11th birthday. Some of you know that I am the founder of the Prosperity Plus programs 1, 2, and 3, and I know that your center has offered these programs to you. I'm a deep believer in tithing. And we all have giving patterns. Many of us give actually only emotionally. We give when we feel like we have a little extra. And then there's another kind of giving that's a regular, repeated giving that comes with a percentage to it. And if it's not 10%, it's 5% or it's 6%, but it comes out of a decision to have circulation in your life, planting in a beautiful place like the Heart and Soul Center of Light for the growth of a community that you has nurtured you, can nurture you further, and more than that, can spread this wonderful message to a world that is deeply hungering, even if they don't know yet that they're hungering for it. So I invite us on this day to lean in and make a commitment for percentage giving over the next year. And then turn around every 3 months and take a look at what's happening in your life. Something happens when you're a regular giver. And each month, as you're receiving your income, a portion of it goes to support. It changes the way you feel about yourself. It changes your level of expectation of good in your life. It changes your sense of worthiness and your connection with the very source of your life.
Thank you, Nicholas Beard. Thank you, Mary Morrissey. Peace and blessings to you, family, wherever you may be in the world. This is Reverend Angelo bringing our opportunities for gracious giving. I just want to take a moment to thank you for the way you have generously supported Heart and Soul Center of Light with your gifts and offerings throughout this year, and also offer as a reminder that when planning your tax-deductible donations for 2020, we hope you'll remember Heart and Soul Center of Light. Your end-of-year donations are so important to supporting Heart and Soul in the work that we're doing, being a world-class teaching and empowerment ministry, and we're so grateful for your financial support as well as your spiritual partnership. We have lots of ways in which you can graciously give at Heart and Soul. You can send a check to our secure mailing address at Heart and Soul Center of Light, 5627 Telegraph Avenue, number 405, Oakland, California, 94609. You can also give online at our website, heartsoulcenter.org/give. And while you're there, you can even set up your gift as a recurring gift or as a one-time gift as you see fit. last but not least, you can text the word GIVE to 510-500-5849. This is my favorite way of giving, but whatever way you choose to give is right and perfect. And it is also important that we maintain the proper consciousness in our giving, blessing our good before it is given, thereby establishing a pathway for the good that our gift will do in the world. And so wherever you happen to be in the world, I invite you to take your gift in hand, or otherwise just place your hand over your heart and let us bless our good together. I bless this gift as healing energy and send it into the divine flow of all good. Infinite prosperity circulates through me, through my church, and throughout the world, because I know God as source.
Thank you, Reverend Angelo, and thank you, Reverend Andrea, for reminding us of the reason for the season and for our lives. Dear ones, I'm going to take us through our opportunities for engagement. Just as a reminder, to join us Monday evening, 6:30 to 7:15 p.m. For our Year of Miracles review, and also that there will be no Imagining Justice this Wednesday, December 23rd, or December 30th. IJ will be reconvening on Wednesday, January the 6th. And thank you again, Heart and Soul, for helping us buy out the Boss toy drive. Please check the list on the slide. The slide will also be available in the recap coming up this week. You can mail your contributions to the address on the slide, and you can also check out the link at the bottom of the slide to see other opportunities for supporting Boss. And a reminder to RSVP for our first virtual New Year's Eve celebration on Thursday, December 31st at 10 p.m. Pacific via Zoom. And you can RSVP at www.heartsoulcenter.org/NYE2020. And please do join our Sister Tammy Hall Thursday evenings, 6 to 8 p.m. on Facebook Live. And please do tip our sister generously. Join us on Saturdays at 10 a.m. Via Facebook, YouTube, or via podcast for our Point of Reverend RGS Point of Power. And we're still celebrating our 11th anniversary, so we ask that you join us by donating in amounts of $11, $111, $1,111, or $11,111. Whatever it is, your gift is greatly appreciated. And also a reminder again that we moved, and to please check out our Amazon wish list. We also invite you to just, donate a gift card, which will help us in getting those things that we need as they are needed. And we continue to support Marcus Books. We want them to continue to be the oldest independent African-American bookstore in the country. So support their 60th anniversary fundraiser. And also, please do continue to support Kingston 11. We definitely want to make sure that we are taking care of those who support us. And The Pulse, our teen ministry, meets at on Sundays at 11:30 a.m. Via Zoom. Actually, if you would like to get your teenager engaged, you can email thepulse@heartsoulcenter.org. And our Youth and Family Village is back with meaningful and fun videos for families to access at their convenience. And to do so, you can email yfv@heartsoulcenter.org. The focus this month is on gratitude, how to make spa water, movement and breath, and music from Ms. B's. And please do not miss the opportunity to receive prayer today. Prayer is available after service. We have four rooms that are available for prayer: word, creative self-expression, prosperity and supply, right action, divine guidance, health and healing, love, relationships, harmony, peace and joy, and a new room for the holidays, moving through the holidays with grace, joy, and connection. And here is Reverend Andriette.
Thank you, Ron. Thank you, Revela. I just want to say thank you for the virtual service team. Y'all know that, you know, several months ago now, we had to, or we chose to turn on a dime and create a virtual service. And that required a team of folks and everybody really addressing what does it take, because it's very different than what we did holding service, live services in the room, And so I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful for the team that is serving now, for those who are on rotation, for all of it. Just a special shout out to Reverend Angelo Allen, because it is through his video work that we are able to broadcast and stream in the way that we do. And frankly, he just makes it so easy for me to do my part. And so I'm grateful. And there are just so many folks on the team, but I just want to shine the light on that central place, because it is key. He is key to this process. Thank you for tuning in. Those of you in the Bay Area, those of you who regularly attended Heart and Soul and are online, just thank you. Thank you for hanging in there. Thank you for showing up. Thank you for continuing to give and support Heart and Soul. Just thank you, thank you, thank you. And if we're new to you, thank you. I'm grateful that you're here. And I just want to give a special shout. By the way, I miss y'all. I miss seeing you. I miss us being in the same energetic space. I know it's going to be weird when the time comes and we're hugging people. I mean, I can already see the, you know, kind of the false starts that we'll have, or those of us who will be like, no, not yet, you know. But I just know that we are in this love together and are open to whatever serves us best in the long term. Special shout out to those of you who are tuning in from places far and wide, like Jaco, Costa Rica, and from Aurora, Colorado, and Tucson, Arizona, and Jackson, Mississippi, and Maui, Hawaii, Connecticut, and Baton Rouge, and Salvador, Bahia, Brazil, as well as Clovis, California, and Boston, Massachusetts. I am so grateful. I know some of you are like, why would I need to tell you where I'm from? But it really is because I want to know. There's something that, you know, it's a little nosy thing that's happening maybe, but it's also because it brings me joy to know that what we're up to is really rippling out. So if you wouldn't mind, whenever you show up, if you would respond to our host and our fabulous team, let me just a shout out to those of you who are supporting the chat, those of you who are greeting folks. We still have greeters and ushers on the line in the same role that they've always been in, which is loving the folks who show up. That's really their core work, is to love and support the folks who show up. So they are still engaged in that. And that is our virtual support folks. We call them octopi. And so we are just loving and appreciating all that they're doing. I just want to thank you, Heart and Soul Center of Light, to all of you who responded to our ask for BOSS. And BOSS stands for Building Opportunities for Self-Sufficiency. They are an organization that works with reentry families. And we asked you to, let's support their toy drive. And we gave you the link. And when I went there this morning so that I could make sure we would give the accurate link, there were nothing left on the list, which we ultimately realized means that y'all bought and it had Amazon send to them everything that they had on the wish list. Now, here's what's true. I know that because we asked them for the wish list, and it's no small task to put it together, I think that they just put together what they could as quickly as they could. But regardless, you did that. And what we know is that they also have a holiday drive that has other things on it, like towels and toiletries and blankets and linens and gift cards. And so there are a number of things that reentry families need, period, but especially during this time. And so we're asking you, just in your own way, if you go to go to Target online or Amazon or Walgreens or whatever, wherever it is you're willing to go physically or do online, if you would have it sent to them or drop it off to them. And their address is 1600 San Pablo Avenue in Oakland. That's their career training and empowerment center. So, an employment center, excuse me, which is an empowerment center, by the way. So, if you would just make sure they get it as soon as possible, and we were going to continue to do. This year, Heart and Soul is making certain that we are giving from our overflow. So, you are helping us do this. Thank you so very much. A quick reminder that Reverend Dr. Will Coleman and I are going to be hosting our New Year's Eve service. This is our first virtual. And so what I know is we're already planning it and it's already good, but it's about releasing 2020, of course, and preparing ourselves, opening ourselves, welcoming 2021. This is essential for the conscious awareness, consciously and intentionally. Let it go, clear the way, and open and make ourselves available to the new, what? New birth, new hope, new life. That's what we're talking about doing. So please support us. At the end of service, I'm going to pray us out, but at the very end, Tammy Hall prepared something quite lovely, and our ensemble participates, and it is just so very lovely. I'm grateful for Annie Stafford and Daria Johnson and the inimitable Tammy Hall. I am grateful. So right now, just join me in prayer in today's reading from A Year of Miracles. Marianne Williamson says, I base my identity on an eternal. So meet me in that awareness, and the awareness that who and whose we are is based on an eternal rock. Life after life after life after life. I'm grateful to know that there is one life, one all-encompassing, divine, whole, perfect, and complete life. The life of the living one, the strong one. That life is living me now. The breath of the living one, the strong one, the eternal rock is breathing me right now. I know that I am breathing the breath of the living one, the strong one. I know that this is true for all of us, that each and every one of us is breathing the breath of the living one, the strong one, and the living one, the strong one is breathing each and every one of us, that all of us, each and every one of us, is living the life of the divine. The living one, the strong one. Right where we are right now, whatever experience we're having, we are living the life of God, and the life of God is living us. There's something about knowing and accepting that we are one in God. I and the Father be one. There's something about realizing that, knowing that, and in faith, believing that there is one life and that each of us is living it. It's the life of God, that there is that divine connectivity. And connectivity doesn't even say it, that there is not a spot where God is not, and that's within and all around me, that God is, I am. God is, we are. And so knowing that, we're empowered to know and to declare that the divine surrounds and enfolds absolutely every millisecond of my life, every millisecond of all life, that there truly is not a spot in my life that is not blessed by the divine. And on this day, I stand in this blessing, I stand in this perfect awareness that is also known as faith.
it that my faith believing in the oneness and that a place is already prepared that is filled to overflowing with divine good right now. And I'm standing in this place declaring new hope, new life, new birth for me, through me, as me, that the divine surrounding and enfolding and imbuing absolutely everything and everyone is transforming our lives. Some of us already know this. This prayer is for those who are wishing and hoping that this is so, that 2021 will be different. That in it's different, that there'll be more love and more inclusion and more acceptance, that there'll be a vibration of inclusion. And I know that it's essential that we begin the prayer now, that we begin the shift now, that we begin to stand in divine knowing in this moment. It truly is done unto us as we believe. So we begin believing now that the shift is now, which ensures that 2021 shows up in a way that is aligned with our heart's desire. A world that is working for everyone. Oh, it is an absolute perfect gratitude that I accept the power in this word. Why? Because it's true, and there is power in the truth. I know that it cannot possibly return to me void, so I launch it. I launch it into the perfect activity of law, which I know is love, the love of the divine. God is love. And so I turn this over. I turn it loose. I release it. I let it be. I know that it's done. And done well in the divine. And for this, I am grateful. So in absolute perfect gratitude, I let go. I let God. And I seal it for all eternity and ask that you might join me by simply declaring, Ashe, Amen, and so it is. And now, Tammy Hall, Annie Stafford. Thank you.
Thank you.